most of the invasive plants that we have in this country fall into one of two categories, accidental or deliberate. Almost all of them are, I would say most or the lion's share, were deliberate introductions initially. So garlic mustard was deliberately introduced. It was a pot herb. Or you get something like multiflora rose that was, practically given away to farmers. Then you get things like Japanese stilt grass. That was an accidental introduction. That was brought here in packing material. It was used as for packing china from Japan when we were occupied Japan. They would use the dried material, seeds included, pack the china up, send it to the U.S., and then it was discarded, and of course it ended up in rail yards and waste areas initially. But the seeds of something like stilt grass cling. They're flat and they stick to things. They'll stick to the hides of animals. They'll stick to your cars, under your cars, and they'll stick to your boots. So a plant like that now is transported largely, probably to new areas, largely by vehicles, yeah. Especially construction equipment and clearing equipment
and ATVs.
Yeah. And then it's
and up and down the Appalachian Trail by hikers.
Yeah, you can find it on the Appalachian Trail. That's brought in by hikers. You can find it in logging areas that were brought in by construction equipment. Yeah. So then you get things like Japanese honeysuckle, which is distributed by birds. Now that most people aren't planting Japanese honeysuckle anymore, even though it was originally introduced as an ornamental. All those invasive plants, and there's a lot of them, are a big hurdle to preserving the woods here in a state in which they can be useful to us as well as being beneficial to the ecology at large. Broadly speaking, burning the woods here helps keep a lot of the invasives out. It keeps the soil open, and which promotes a lot of fresh germination of a lot of plants, and many plants won't germinate or thrive in the woods without a fire. So many older forests, the forest understory declines and declines and declines until it's either gone or everything is just in a state of hibernation.
Essentially living hibernation.
Yeah. Waiting for
stasis.
A fire or a hurricane to blow over all the trees or something to bring all that back. So you have, I would say those are kind of the two or three main reasons we do the burning: to promote new germination of plants that require fire for the seeds to germinate, to improve stands of existing plant material which need a fire to keep the forest open and clear, and lastly, to keep invasive plants in check, and invasive insects too, for that matter.
Doing a burn, it gives you a rare opportunity to see nature do amazing things with what appeared to have been a destructive force but turns out to be a life-giving force. Yeah. And we also appreciate the beauty of nature and certain plants that are particularly attractive. And we burned it with a few plant species in mind in particular to bring back from the dead. We call them zombies because they were literally the walking dead, because they were starved of the force that they needed to thrive and produce seed. There's one plant in particular which you will see, and it happens to be in full bloom, called the white or variegated milkweed. And we are hoping that it will produce seed, which it has never produced while I've lived here.
And it's never bloomed as heavily as this either, I don't believe.
Never, ever has it bloomed like it is blooming now.